Hello, I'm David Brown from the SOLIDWORKS Training Team. In this video, I'll show you how to work more efficiently by leveraging the shortcut bars to access common commands quickly. I'll also show you how to customize a shortcut bar with the commands that I use most often. In SOLIDWORKS, once you are finished fully defining a sketch, you can extrude the profile without closing the sketch by activating the command from the command ribbon. With shortcut bars, SOLIDWORKS allows many commonly used commands to appear right next to your mouse cursor. Pressing the S key on your keyboard makes a shortcut bar appear right next to your mouse, eliminating excess cursor travel. The shortcut bar has a field where you can search for commands. Here, as I begin to type the name of the command I want, SOLIDWORKS intelligently monitors what I'm typing and provides a list of commands. In this case, extruded boss base. I can make modifications to the values and right-click to complete the command. My mouse hardly moved at all. You can customize the shortcut bar by clicking the drop-down next to the options or gear icon and selecting Customize. Select the tab titled Shortcut Bars. Notice there is a shortcut bar for each environment: Part, Assembly, Drawing, and Sketch. Most of the time, when I'm finished with a sketch, I am going to create an extruded boss or an extruded cut, so I want to add those commands to the sketch shortcut bar. I'll choose features from the list at left and drag and drop the commands I want right onto the shortcut bar. I also would like to add the base flange command for sheet metal as well. If at a later time you want to remove an icon, simply drag and drop it from the shortcut bar in this same dialog. Now I will add a hole at the top of this part. From within the sketch, I can press the S key to launch the shortcut bar and launch the command directly. You may also notice that I'm using mouse gestures as well. By using mouse gestures and shortcut bars, I can do most of my designing without excessive mouse movements, thereby increasing my efficiency. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this content helpful, please visit the site below to access a video-based lesson on modifying the SOLIDWORKS user interface.